In 1921, a baby boy was born in Texas in the United States. He was not even 2 years old when his family set out on unpaved roads in search of employment opportunities in California. During the Great Depression, the family moved 25 times and the boy attended a total of 11 different schools. It was at Montebello High School that he took his first chemistry class, and he was immediately interested. The boy, Bruce Merrifield, later won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for the invention of peptide synthesis. In 1943, Bruce graduated from the University of California, Los Angeles. He took a job as a laboratory technician at the Philip R. Perk Research Foundation, where he cared for the rat and chicken colonies, feeding them, weighing them, and cleaning their cages. Now, at the end of the year, Bruce realized that he must return to graduate school if he wants to design his own research projects. Bruce returned to UCLA as a graduate student this time and received a teaching assistantship in the biochemistry course. The teaching assistantship gave Bruce a very important opportunity in his life. He met a very pretty girl with long red hair in the class. The girl, Elizabeth, later became his wife. Bruce and Elizabeth enjoyed tennis, ice skating, hiking, and camping. When Bruce received his first paycheck from UCLA, he bought an engagement ring and proposed marriage. Shortly before Bruce completed his doctoral thesis, he was offered a one-year research assistantship in the Rockefeller Institute for Medical Research, which is now Rockefeller University in New York. To accept this offer in New York, he needed to assume the position on July 1st. July 1st, 1949. So he graduated with his PhD on June 19th, and married with Elizabeth on June 20th. The next day, the new couple left for New York City on a camping honeymoon. Then he was able to get the job on July 1st in New York. At the Rockefeller Institute, Dr. Merrifield was greatly influenced by excellence of faculty. His initial one-year contract was renewed in 1950, and he was appointed at the rank of assistant professor. He then was promoted to associate professor in 1958 and to full professor in 1966. Dr. Merrifield investigated newly discovered bioactive peptides at the time. How can you make sure that chemical structures of the newly discovered bioactive peptides? The best way to confirm their structures is the chemical synthesis. At that time, the chemical synthesis of peptides was tedious. It took 11 months to complete the synthesis of a 6-amino acid peptide. That's why Dr. Merrifield developed a new way to synthesize peptides in 1959. The method is now called solid phase synthesis of peptides. So I explained solid phase synthesis earlier when I talked about the chemical synthesis of DNA. In solid phase synthesis, we enlarge the size of one of the two mutually reacting molecules by attaching the molecule to the large bees. So here's a large bees. You attach one of the two molecules. The specifically, we attach the first amino acid to the large bees. This is the first amino acid in the peptide. And we add an excess amount of second amino acid to couple it to the first one through the peptide bond. Then residual amino acid can easily be washed away. Then you get peptide with the two amino acids. This cycle can be repeated until the target peptide is synthesized on the bees. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Something like that. So this is a peptide with the 5 amino acids. The synthesized peptide is then cleaved from the bees. You can cut this. Then you can get the peptide. This procedure is exactly the one Dr. Merrifield wrote down in his notebook dated May 26, 1959. This original protocol is almost identical to the procedure we use today for peptide synthesis. When Dr. Merrifield began his experiment, he thought he would be able to complete it in 3 months. The experiment actually took much longer because he had to spend much more time than expected for the processes of identifying the ideal bees type, optimizing the reaction conditions, and identifying the way to prevent undesirable reactions. In the next video clip, I'll show you the way we eventually use for the chemical synthesis of peptides.